Ezekiel 3:17. Uh-huh. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Mm-hmm. Therefore I had a word at my mouth, and give them warning from me.
So the Bible says, son of man, I have made thee a watchman. A watchman to the house of Israel. What does a watchman do? A watchman tells the people when danger is coming. Read that again, brother.
Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Unto the house of Israel. Not anyone. Not anybody out there. Unto the house of Israel. Read.
Therefore I had a word in my mouth.
Hear the Bible at his mouth. Read on.
And give them warning from me.
And give them warning. Warning from what? If you don't repent, everybody's going to die out here. That's the warning. Read that again, brother.
Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Therefore I had a word in my mouth, and give them warning from me.
Give them warning from me. That's it on that? Go to Zephaniah 2 and 1. Actually, you know what? Read the next verse. Read the next verse. Sorry.
Ezekiel
3
and 18.
Uh-huh.
When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die.
When he says unto the wicked, you unrepentant Israelites are there. You unrepentant Bahamians, thou shalt surely die. Read on.
And thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way.
Right, because that's our job. We're not out here to look crazy to you. We ain't out here to play no games with you. We out here to tell you if you don't repent, you're going to die. Read on.
To save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity.
Uh-huh.
But his blood will I require at thine hand.
Drop that against Zephaniah 2 and 1. Zephaniah 2 and 1. Let's get to the point.
Zephaniah verse 2, verse 1. Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together, O nation, not desire.
So the Bible commands us to gather together. Gather together and what? Gather together and keeping the commandments as Israelites. That's how we gather ourselves together. Read the last part of that verse.
O nation, not desire.
O nation, not desire. Because ain't nobody desire y'all. The other nations hate us. So we so worried about politics and referendums and gender equality. That ain't gonna fix nothing. Read that again, bro.
Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together. O nation, not desire.
See, we need to gather together. That's what the Bible commands us to do. No vote in referendums. No worry about gender equality. We are.
Before the decree bring forth.
Uh-huh.
Before the day pass, as the shaft.
Before the Most High judges everybody out here. You know?
Before the fast anger of the Lord come upon you.
Uh-huh.
Before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you.
Drop that again, Isaiah 30. Isaiah chapter 30 and 1. Because we so busy worried about politics out here. We need to be gathering ourselves together. Isaiah 30 and 1. Let's see what the Bible says about your referendum. Read that.
Isaiah chapter 30 verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord.
Uh-huh.
That take counsel, but not of me.
Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord. Death and destruction to the rebellious children. Who rebellious children? The children of Israel. You Bahamians out here. You blacks out here. You Hispanics out here. You Haitians out here. Death and destruction for you. Why? Read that again, bro.
Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord,
uh-huh.
that take counsel, but not of me.
That take counsel, but not of me. Man, you take counsel of Christianity. You take counsel of the PLP. You take counsel of the FNM. Read on.
And that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit.
That cover with politics. That cover with religion. That cover with gender equality and referendums, but not of the Bible. Read on.
That they may add sin to sin.
That they may add sin to sin. More wicked and more wicked every day. Read on.
That walk to go down into Egypt.
Uh-huh.
And have not asked in my mouth.
That walk to go down into Egypt. Now this ain't talking about literal Egypt. Because Israel never went back into literal Egypt. Read on.
To straighten themselves in the strength
uh-huh.
of Pharaoh. And to trust in the shadow of Egypt.
To trust in the shadow of Egypt. The shadow of Egypt. Where's the shadow? The shadow is something that's there but not really there. It's talking about America. It's talking about America's politics that we always trust in. Because we get this stuff from the white mind. Gender equality is never the agenda of the Bible. We get that from the white mind trying to be like him. Read that from the top, bro.
Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord,
uh-huh.
that take counsel, but not of me.
Right.
That cover with a covering, but not of my spirit.
That cover with a covering, but not of his spirit. Ghetto 0-8-4. Let's get there right quick. Hold that Ghetto 0-8-4. Hosea 8-4. We too worried about politics. Hosea 8-4. You got it? Let me see that. Start from verse 3.
Hosea 8, verse 3. Uh-huh. Israel hath cast off the thing that is good.
You behemoths have cast off the thing that is good. What is good? Hold up, bro. I know you got you on that. Get Romans 7:14. Romans 7:14. You behemoths have cast off the thing that is good. Let's see what the Bible says good is. Because good ain't Christianity. Good ain't white man Jesus. Good ain't dancing, hopping up and down in the Christian church. Read that, bro.
Romans 7:14.
Verse 12.
Wherefore the law is holy, uh-huh, and the commandment holy, uh-huh, and just, uh-huh, and good.
So the commandments are good. That's what you have cast off. Go back to Hosea 8:4 now. Let's get the thought.
Hosea 8:4.
Right.
They have set up kings, uh-huh, but not by me.
Verse 3.
Israel has cast off the thing that is good.
Israel has cast off the law of the Bible. That's what we've cast off. We are.
The enemy shall pursue him. Uh-huh. They have set up kings, but not by me.
So who are the kings that we have set up? Perry Christie? Hubert Minnis, Hubert Ingram, that's the case that we've set up. Telling us we got to vote on gender equality, that's supposed to fix anything. We still going to have fatherless homes. We still going to have murder. We still going to be raping and robbing out there. What gender equality is supposed to do? You foolish people. Read that again.
They have set up kings, but not by me.
Uh-huh.
They have made princes and knew it not.
Right. They have made these foolish leaders out there. Does it or not?
Read
off. Of their silver and their gold, have they made them idols,
uh-huh,
that they may be cut off.
That they may be cut off. Judge, get Malachi 4:1. Malachi 4:1. Let's see what the judgment is going to be for saying in these dumb politics. Malachi 4:1. Let me see that.
Malachi 4.
Read that, bro.
For behold, the day cometh,
uh-huh,
that shall burn as an oven.
The day of the Lord, that's what it's talking about. That shall burn as an oven. Nuclear destruction, even to this place. Read on.
And all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly, shall be stubble.
See, all of you on your stupid politics shall be stubble in that day. Burned up. You need to repent. Read on.
And the day that cometh,
uh-huh,
shall burn them up,
uh-huh,
saith the Lord of hosts,
uh-huh,
that it shall leave them neither root nor branch.
It shall burn them up. Go to 2 Peter 3.
I think it's chapter 3. Let me see. I think I want you to start at verse 8.
Here's a judgment for what you're going to get into your politics. Here's a judgment. Second side of verse 3:3.
2 Peter chapter 3 verse 3.
Right.
Knowing this verse, that there shall come in the last days scoffers.
There shall come in the last days scoffers. The last days is now. There shall come scoffers, men who hate the word. So you think we look stupid out here? We look like a bunch of clowns in our Power Ranger suits. Scoffers, men who hate the word. The Bible prophesies of this. See, your Christian church pastors, they're not scoffed at. They're looked at as leaders.
That's right.
The scriptures say the true men of the Lord are going to be scoffed at.
We are. That's right.
Walking after their own lust.
Walking after their own lust. Their own agendas.
That's right.
We on, bro.
And saying, where is the promise of his coming?
Where is the promise of his coming? So y'all think nothing is going to change. Well, in this dumb politics. Read on, bro.
For since the fathers fell asleep,
uh-huh,
all things continue as they were from the beginning.
Right, since the forefathers died, nothing changed. We just said, doing our little dumb shuckling and jiving and all that. Ain't nothing changing. Christ ain't coming back. Read on, but you're ignorant of something. Read on.
All things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation.
Right.
For this, they willingly are ignorant of.
Right, you're willingly stupid. Willingly stupid. Why? Let's find out.
That by the word of God, the heavens were of old,
uh-huh,
and the earth standing out of the water and in the water.
Three.
Whereby the word that then was, being overflowed with water, perished.
Right. Meaning, at that time, the Most High flooded the entire earth. But the earth today is kept in store for a different judgment. Let's read.
But the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same word, are kept in store,
uh-huh,
reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
Read that one more time. Read slow.
But the heavens and the earth.
But the heavens and the earth. meaning the ruling nations, the poor nations, first world countries or third world countries as we call it today, are kept in store for what?
Which are now, by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire, reserved unto fire, against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
Are kept in store for fire, nuclear destruction. That's the judgment for this place and now. Referendums. Kept in store for nuclear destruction. You need to repent, Israel. Read on.
But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing. That one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness.
See, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise. He's not going to say something and not do it. So if he says he's going to destroy this place, he's going to do it. But it's taking so long for a reason. See, he's trying to give you a chance, you know.
But it's long-suffering But is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish.
But is patient to us, not willing that any of us should die. See, it's taking so long because the Most High is trying to give you a chance to repent. Good. It's not because he's slack concerning his promise. See, you gotta repent of these politics. You gotta repent of your Christianity, or all of you are going to die. So you have the chance now. You are being called today, believe it or not. You know?
But that all should come to repentance.
That all should come to repentance. Repenting in the faith of Christ. Keeping the commandments as Israelites. Read on.
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
But the day of the Lord shall come as a thief in the night. See, it's going to sneak up on you. You're not going to know when it's coming. Your stupid pastors in the church, you ain't know when it's coming. It's going to sneak up on you right when you're paying tithes in the church. You know.
In the which the heaven shall pass away with a great noise.
In the which the heaven shall pass away with the great noise. What's that great noise? The boom when them bombs drop. That's the great noise. Read on.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat. See, y'all think the Bible is a fairy tale. It's talking about nuclear destruction. Read on.
And the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up.
And the earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. All that you see before you shall be burned up. Read on.
Seeing then that all these men shall be dissolved. What manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation?
Seeing then that all these things are going to be dissolved, what manner of person are you going to be? Are you going to be caught up in gender equality? Well, that's going to fix anything. Are you going to be caught up in constitutional referendums? Are you going to be caught up in Christianity and white man Jesus? Or are you going to repent like the Bible is telling us to do? What kind of person are you going to be knowing that you are going to die for your sins? You know?
And godliness. Looking for and hasting unto the coming of the day of God.
Drop that again, Matthew 4 and 1.
I think that's it.
Matthew 4 and 1. Because Christ says the same thing. Matthew 4 and 1. Let me look at it. Nah, not Matthew 4. Repent ye for the kingdom of heaven. Matthew 3 and 2.
Matthew chapter 3, verse 2. Uh-huh. And saying, repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, brothers and sisters. You have to repent. Stop being so willingly ignorant, willingly stupid. Walking around and breaking the Sabbath day. Walking around and committing all manner of wickedness. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent ye, or you're going to die.
Right.
Read that again, bro.
Matthew 3, verse 2. Uh-huh. And saying, repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Let's get Ephesians 4. Ephesians chapter 4. I think I want to start with verse 13. Let me look at it. Start of verse 14.
Ephesians 4, verse 14. Uh-huh. That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine.
That we henceforth be no more children. Because what do children do? They believe everything. See, you believe everything Barry Christie tell you. You believe everything your commanders tell you. You believe everything your politicians and your super pastors tell you. Children, you don't think. Carried to and fro. Read that again.
Carried, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine.
Carried about with every wind of doctrine. Christianity, politics. Carried about, you know,
by the sleight of men,
by the trickery of men, the deceit of your politicians, because they're doing it for their own agendas, you know,
and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive,
Rabbi, they lie in wait to deceive. Jump down to verse 22.
Alright. Ephesians 4, verse 22. That he put off concerning the former conversation.
Verse 22.
That he put off concerning the former conversation, the old man.
That he put off concerning the former conversation, the old man. See, this is the steps to repentance. This is how he begins to change our lives. It's not through dancing and doing some foolishness in the Christian church. That you put off the former conversation of the old behemoth. The old Haitian. Read that again.
That he put off concerning the former conversation of the old man. Which is corrupt according to deceitful lusts.
Which is corrupt according to deceitful lusts. Wicked as hell. According to your deceitful lusts. What kind of lusts? Like breaking the Sabbath day. Like raping, robbing, stealing. Like being in politics, being in Christianity. Adultery, idolatry. Read on, bro.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
That's right.
Meaning repentance in the faith of Christ. That's how you become renewed. Read on.
And that ye put on the new man.
That ye put on Christ, the new man. So that you now can become an Israelite. Not a behemoth, not a Haitian, because you were brought here on slave ships. You didn't come here willingly. Read on.
Which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness.
Which after God is created in righteousness. What's righteousness? Deuteronomy 6:25, bro. Hold on. Let's find out what righteousness is. Look at it. Mm-hmm.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 25. Right. And it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do all these commandments.
It shall be our righteousness, the Israelites' righteousness, if we do the commandments. Righteousness is not what you think it is. Righteousness ain't going to church on Sunday. That ain't about to do nothing for you. Go back to where you was, bro. Verse 24.
And Ephesians 4, verse 24. And that he put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness.
That you put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness. Keeping the law. Holiness. Keeping the law. Read that one more time, bro.
And that he put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness.
Which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Get Matthew 19. Matthew 19. Yeah, Matthew 19 verse 16, but let's get that. Let's see what our Lord and Savior says. Because he says the same thing. So repentance is keeping the law, right? Read that, bro.
Matthew 19, verse 16. Uh-huh. And behold, one came and said unto him, right. Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?
What good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? See, this man was asking our Lord and Savior that. What good thing shall I do so that I can get into heaven? As everybody likes to say. That I can get the kingdom. Let's make it simple. Read on.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life,
if thou wilt enter into life, eternal life, read on.
Keep the commandments.
Keep the commandments.
That's
right. Keep the commandments. See, that's what we're commanded to do. Not vote for your dumb politics. That's not what we're commanded to do. And we're here to tell you that because your leaders are not going to tell you. Go back to Isaiah 30. I think I want verse 2. Go back to Isaiah 30 and verse, let me see, read verse 20.
Isaiah 30 and verse 20, right? And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity.
And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity. Read on.
And the water of affliction.
And the water of affliction. Meaning hard bondage. Though he gives you that. Because a lot of y'all don't think you're in captivity. This is bondage, brothers and sisters. Read on.
Yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, For thine eyes shall see thy teachers, and thine ears shall hear a word behind thee.